Welcome to today's episode of Vlogmas. Today's going to be a quick video. I am showing you my closet tour. So literally starting in the master bedroom, I'm showing you my closet, my beauty room. This was a super, super highly requested video. So I'm really excited to film it for you guys. This is nothing fancy, but this is just how I organize my closet. And I've never done one of these videos before on my channel. So I'm pumped and welcome to the closet slash beauty cabinet. Cabinet, is that? That's weird. That's weird. Beauty tour? Whatever. Welcome to the video. Your girl was not ready. When you walk into the closet here on the left, you basically just have my very puffy winter jackets and vests. These are just from Hollister, the fluffy ones from Hollister. I've got the Lulu Down For It All jacket, some dry goods, Lulu vest, and then this is a North Face one that I just got for my birthday. Love it. So pretty much anything in this corner is just wintry puffy jackets and vests. Then over here, this is my little shoe rack that I got from Target. Super easy to put together and super cheap. It was like 20 some dollars. But right now these are kind of all my wintry shoes and then some heels if I do have to go out for anything. And then I have some sandals hidden in one of these boxes up here. But for the most part, this is where I keep my shoes. And these little guys, which I got from Thiessen's actually, these are just little house slippers and I love them. They're so comfortable. On this side, these boxes are also from Target. They're just the Target brand organization boxes. I just prefer to have things in boxes, even if it's just thrown in there, because I don't like the way it looks when there's just stuff all over the shelves, you know? Got like extra sheets and stuff in here, extra Tula things and makeup bags, hats and scarves, more hats, technology and wiry stuff, and then camera bag. And this one, it's not, like I said, super organized, but I just prefer the look of it like this. Now this might seem super weird that I have these random dog things here, but I'm collecting little dog frames and things like that, that one I got from Pixels and Wood, because I'm gonna make a gallery wall of Tucks and Bailey. I cannot wait to show you guys. I'm so pumped. So that's kind of above this little dresser here, which is also from Target. In that corner is nothing really. That's just like a camera bag, some scrapbooking things, and then my gimbal down there. I just kind of shove that in the corner. In this top drawer, I just have some long sleeve shirts and anything that you can use for layering for this winter that goes in here. And then on this side, it's just bras and bralettes, lacy things like that. In the second drawer is the workout shirt drawer, which as you can see is organized by color because I like to be able to find a shirt when I need it. And I just think of things off the top of my head in colors. I know that's weird, but I have my blacks over here, whites in the corner, neutrals, grays, and then colors on this section. And this is the Marie Kondo method of folding, where you like flip them up so that you can see what's in there. And it's just really helpful. It doesn't let it get to be super messy because you don't have to dig through piles of stuff, you know? So love that. Although I will say my legging drawer is not really organized like that one is. This is kind of just folded and laid in there. But on this side, I have everything that's Athleta. Then I've got pattern Lulu stuff here, solid Lulu here, and then Fleo stuff in this corner. And these are really my favorite types of leggings. I don't wear anything else other than Fleo, Lulu, and Athleta. They hold their quality so well and they are so stinking great. So that's that drawer. The bottom, which is not currently getting used and also is kind of messy. I did not prepare myself for this video. I'm just keeping it real. This is what my dresser looks like all the time. This is shorts because it's so cold. I'm not wearing any shorts right now, but in this corner is Wool Sport. And then these are literally all Fleo shorts. Like, look at this. I love Fleo. I do have some running Lulu shorts, but even when I was wearing shorts, I don't wear those as frequently as I wear my Fleo shorts. So then, on this wall of the closet is basically just anything that I could wear, quote unquote, out. Not like your girl's going out much, but you know what I'm saying, like real people clothes. In this corner is businessy stuff, then I have dresses. These dresses are from Free People. I have them in three colors because I love it so much. Shorter dresses, and then I've got longer rompers, dressier tank tops and dressy shirts. I have some long sleeve shirts here, and then it kind of goes into plaid shirts and jean jackets, which by the way, this is from Dry Goods, obsessed. My sweater collection, which is rapidly growing. Most of them are from Target and Dry Goods. I'm telling you, like this one, this is from Target.
Okay, look how cute that is. And they're so affordable too. Like, I don't know about you guys, but I'm just not really one that's gonna spend like a ton of money on clothing. I don't know. I would really more so rather spend money on like food and things that are going into my body versus clothing. I do have quite a bit of, what do they call this? Wool, I guess, wool sweatering, because I just love this material so much. So these are from dry goods here. A couple of them are from Target, and then I have like some American Eagle and Billabong in there as well. Those are like some cardigans. And then on this side just goes into like the Lulu athletic kind of style with jackets and sweatshirts, and then my robe over here and a thingy to hang my scarves on. So this is pretty much what you see when you walk into the closet this way, and this is stuff that I would be using if I was actually getting ready, like to go somewhere and not just like be cozy. But to be cozy, which is the best part, this dresser over here kind of houses my sports bras, which are literally a disaster, but pretty much all of these guys are Lulu, and the Free to Be Wild bra is like kind of my OG. So if you're looking for a good sports bra, highly recommend that. And the drawer underneath that is all pajama stuff. So I've got like boyfriend shirts here, which mostly I stole from Austin, more form-fitting pajama shirts there. And then these are all pajama pants, which I get a lot of these guys at TJ Maxx or Marshalls. They've got a great pajama bottom selection. So bottom drawer here is just sweatpants. So lighter ones, medium and heavy sweatpants in that drawer, nothing crazy. This drawer over here is more so comfy sweatshirts that I would wear like if I'm just waking up and I'm cold and I want to wear a sweatshirt from the house or to the gym or something. They're just more so soft and things that you can throw on top of your gym clothes. And then in the bottom drawer is what I like to call my normal people drawer. So shorts, which are obviously not getting used, regular jeans, and then flowy pants and things of that nature, which I did wear a lot during the summer, but not now. Oh my gosh, wait. Look at this angel. He dug himself a little hole. Tux, you are so cute. I cannot. He literally messed up this whole bed just to make that little nook. And you are beautiful. What a nice girl. Oh my gosh, look at that snoot. Look at those little whiskers in your lip. Can we see a teeth? Let me see a teeth. Anyways, so when you walk out here, this is the gallery wall that I was talking about making into a Tux and Bailey wall over here, because I already have this picture, which a tattoo artist painted for me from down in South Florida. And then this little Rescued Is My Favorite Breed sign from Hobby Lobby. But this wall is big enough to do a gallery wall on. So I'm really excited about it, because I'm sure you've seen this gallery wall in the guest bathroom, but I really had fun putting this together, and I just think it would be so cute to do one of Tux and Bailey. So I'll keep you guys updated on that. But when you walk into the guest bathroom, these lovely, whatever I guess you would call them, cabinets, is where I store all of my makeup and beauty products. These cabinets are so great, and they're so deep, so you can get a ton of stuff in there. So I'm not gonna show you every single product, but I will show you some of my favorites, because when I post this on Instagram, a lot of people said they actually wanted to see what products I have in here. So I'll show you some things, but we'll just kind of try to get through this as quickly as possible. We'll start from the top guy here, which is just a little acrylic lipstick holder that Erin gave me. And these guys are kind of ones that I don't use too often. So like Milani, I have some random like NYX liquid lips. I've got just, you know, like some random ones that I just don't find myself reaching for too often, I put in this guy. Then next to it, this little container I got from Home Goods, and I love this so much because you can see actually what's in them. Right here I have everything that is lip pencils, anything from Thrive Cosmetics, Anastasia, Milani, things like that. So those are lip pencils. And the one next to it is all liquid lips. So whether it be matte or just ones that I find myself using more frequently. This one is a Makeup Forever one that I love. All of these are nudes, to tell you the truth, like whether it's Anastasia or whatever, it's kind of more of a neutral base in this one. So I would go to those more so than the crazy colorful ones, you know. This one to the left is all mascaras, and these two are really my only ones that I find myself using constantly. They're both Too Faced, Damn Girl, and Better Than Sex. But I do have this It Cosmetics one that I showed you in my Get Ready With Me, which is one that I use for my lower lashes. The other ones I just don't really use too often, but I do have them as a backup. And the last container is all eyebrow stuff, which mostly is Anastasia. I have the clear brow gel. I've got two different colors of the regular brow gel, the pens. I somehow have three pens.
and the Thrive Cosmetics one that I used in my last Get Ready With Me, which is in the color Audrey. I love this a lot. It's really nice. So that's everything that's in this, and I do use this one quite a bit when I'm getting ready for things. Then on the second shelf, these guys are also from Target, these organization baskets. So is that one in the back. This is the same as this one, which I got from Home Goods. I think it came in a set. So everything that's in this little container is kind of what I use on the daily, like things that I reach for every single day. So the little lip glosses, the contour stick, concealer, I've got primers in here, two of the buildable blur CC creams, the bronzing drops, and the setting spray. So this is stuff that I know is kind of like my ride or die right now, so I keep in there. And then in this middle basket is basically just face palettes, but I do keep my eyelashes in here as well. I have like some contour kits. I've got the Tarte Pro Glow one, which I do really like, by the way. I haven't used this in a while, and I love how they always smell like chocolate. The Benefit Cheeky Cheek Leader one, Kat Von D, Anastasia, Becca, and then this random lip palette that I haven't even used yet. This is from Ish Cosmetics. I've never even heard of that. I don't know where that even came from. Right is obviously just brushes. I got this cute little guy at Home Goods, and the only way I really have these organized is just eyeshadow stuff in the right, and then all face brushes are to the left. In the back is just little samples. This is like my sample drawer from when I go to Sephora and Ulta. Then these guys here, I have these three buckets organized by face powders and blushes and highlights. So when you go in here, you have like your setting powders, cookie highlighter, that's not supposed to be in there, sponges and bronzers and things like that. So basically for the face, but more so of a powder. And then this one is mostly just face stuff, but cream. So any extra CC creams I have an extra one of those Too Faced Hangover RX primers, another Glam Glow primer, which I really like, by the way. I just haven't been using it as often because I'm still loving the Hangover RX one. Extra concealers and things like that. And then my eyeshadow stuff has been popping lately. I've been really trying some new eyeshadows. So basically this is all eye stuff. I've got mostly Morphe, Jaclyn Hill stuff. I've got an Anastasia palette, Tarte, another one of the Jaclyn Hills. This is really cute, this Hot Buttered Rum palette from Too Faced. I love these colors so much. They are so great for a holiday look. I have some extra random lipsticks in here because I didn't have enough room in my little acrylic thing. I just have my hair thing. So this is my curling irons in straightener in that one. And then my blow dryer, a brush, and another curling iron in here. Not super organized, but I don't really care too much about that. And then my bottom one is all hair products. So I've got hair ties and things like that in here. All my Junk Brand headbands in that one. And then these buckets are not really organized in a specific way. However, this side is mostly stuff that I use all the time. So like, this is my go-to hair oil. This is by Olifika. It's my favorite hair oil. I have this Davines oil milk that I use before I'm blow drying. And then also a texturizing spray from Davines, which I love a lot. This one smells so good. Oh my gosh. And then these are kind of just like extra products that I don't really use too often, but I keep if I need, like some hairsprays and stuff like that. So that's pretty much everything that's in this drawer right here, and that's basically all my beauty products. So I hope you guys enjoyed this little beauty room slash closet tour. If you did, please give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to click subscribe, and I will see you in my next vlog.